Yeah, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Engineer Noel Ngoi. I am a structural and drainage engineer. My presentation today is about a discussion on issues about
flood prediction and mitigation measures in Tanzania. Flooding is a problem worldwide affecting our rural and urban areas. This is aggravated by climatic changes. Tanzania is no exception on this issue. In this paper, we are going to discuss on the following issues. First, the adequacy of the available flood prediction methods. Second is whether town planning is affecting the flood mitigation measures. And thirdly, we are going to discuss on the issue of institutional cooperation between the government institutions dealing with flood prediction and mitigation. There is a big problem in town planning since we got independence in Tanzania. And this has resulted in floods affecting our towns in Tanzania. Dar es Salaam
is one of the examples of flooding in Tanzania. Normally, the blame is placed on infrastructure, always. One time I was called in EATV, Mhandisi uje tueleze juu ya mafuriko ya Tanzania na miundombinu. I told them that the problem is not miundombinu, the problem is planning. If you don't have proper planning, then you are not going to be able to control hazards like floods. There is a problem in town planning. You know, in Tanzania, since we got independence, we did not take care of planning. Everybody was constructing as he or she knows. And even the planning which have been done in our towns is not done thoroughly. For example, you may find the town planners are planning, but they don't involve the infrastructure people. So those dealing with the infrastructure come in when they are constructing the infrastructures. For example, one time I was constructing a road in Songea. I was the project manager for the contractor. And then I found that there is a problem on drainage. There is a river across that project whereby I could just provide cross drainage and make sure that the water can join the river. But near that river, there is a plot for somebody. I approached the leaders, please, I want to discharge water there. They say, no, that plot belongs to somebody. So you'll find a lot of plots which are constructed on low-lying areas. There is issue of cooperation between government institutions. There is the water department, there is Tarura Tanros who are dealing with main and trunk roads and urban and rural roads. But I don't see that there is cooperation on the issue of flooding, especially on flood prediction between those institutions. So as I said, that since independence, town planning have not been any priority. Now, of course, there is a priority in town planning, but we are giving priority so that everybody should know where his plot is, but not town planning to also take on board other infrastructures like roads, electricity, drainage, sewerage, etc. In Dar es Salaam, there are some low-lying areas which have been constructed, like the Msasani area. That Msasani area should be a place to allow for water to go to the sea, but people have just raised their plots, and they have constructed, and they have got legal documents for ownership of those areas. You cannot remove them there. Sometimes you find on the roads that the water wants to get out, but the water cannot have no place to move, to go. So it comes back to the road. And then they say, hey, maandisi wa miundombinu tuambie, kwa nini kuna matatizo ya miundombinu? Where can you take the water? Also, there is a problem of pollution and sewerage systems discharging water to the floods. For example, in Sinza and in the Msimbazi River. One issue is we have not done enough research to be able to, to predict the floods. We need to be able to predict the floods properly so that we may construct a proper infrastructure to the floods. And also we need to even to be able to notify people that there is a flood coming, please move away. Okay, we have got the East African model. I will not, of course, I've written it in the paper. I will not discuss on it because, you know, time is not on my side. There's the river gauging method where you put some, rulers to gauge the water passing the rivers. And then we've got statistical method. So the rational formula, you know, but this rational formula is limited on to 0.8 square kilometers. So if you have got a bigger area, you cannot use the rational formula. There is the, and also it is used for mainly for urban areas. We have got the TRRI East African model, which was developed by our friends in Kenya and Uganda. And of course, this is how it works. I'm not going to give explanation because of the time on how it works. That is the rational formula. Now I want to tell you the limitations of the TRRL East African flood model, which is used in Tanzania. First, the research was done only in Kenya and Uganda. And of course, Tanzania was not involved. Tanzania was, they just, our friends in Kenya and Uganda and East African, spirit, they just said, okay, this is Mombasa. Mombasa is like Tanga, it's like Mtwara. So Mtwara and Tanga can use this. This is like Mbeya, so Mbeya can use this. It was not developed in Tanzania. And the research was carried on in 1966. You know, it is a long time, and the climate has changed. So you cannot just say, we are just going on with the East African flood model without doing a research, a further research. Then the duration of the rainfall storm was only 4 years. That is another limitation. Very limited data were used to develop the model. And now we have a lot of data. And then the design storm was developed for 10 years duration period. But you know, the minimum for design of culverts is 25 years, and for bridges is 50 years. You can see the limitation. It provides no room to use current rainfall. We have got a lot of rainfall data, but you don't put rainfall in your model when you want to estimate the discharge. The discharges are obtained only to small and medium areas, limited to 2,200 square kilometers. I have been involved in the design of a bridge in Ruangwa. The the catchment area is 8,200 square kilometers. And this year, I had a privilege to be prevented to move in near Ngaresero by the flood. The catchment area for that flood, the Monique River, is 5,000 square kilometers. So you cannot use this model for such catchment areas. Gauging of the rivers to determine discharges is normally done by the ministry. So you can see that The East African flood model is limited. So if you want to design a bridge in a area with catchment area, a big catchment area like the Mbwemkuru Bridge in Ruangwa, you need just to talk with elders. You find an elder say, "Mimi huru nilipokuja nilitazama machoni." So that guy can tell you, can give you the history of that area. And that is what you are going to rely upon when you design your bridge, because the model we are having cannot cater for such a big area. There is another approach of river gauging. Gauging of rivers to determine discharges is normally done by the ministry responsible for water supply. The rivers to be gauged are selected depending on the requirements of the ministry, so do not necessarily conform to the requirements of TANROADS and TARURA. There is need to cooperate between, these government institutions so that they may be able to develop, to even to select the rivers to be gauged, not only according to the requirements for the Ministry of Water, but also, TARURA and TANROADS. Of course, the statistical method, I've never seen it being applied in Tanzania. Government cooperation between the government institutions is very important. And then we come to conclusions and recommendations. Measures for planning and preparation of flood models is not enough. So we need to do more research. There is a need to introduce drainage management plans for example, for the Msimbazi River. Town planning should not be done by town planners alone, but should incorporate other experts, like infrastructural experts. Separate master plans are important for main rivers crossing our towns. Then, upgrading of East African flood model is important to meet requirements for bigger catchment areas and Tanzanian requirements in general. We need cooperation between government institutions dealing with flood management, and also it is recommended for the road agencies to employ hydrologists for such assignment. It is important to prepare a flood management master plan, especially for Dar es Salaam, and then we should consider rescue services when the flooding occurs. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for listening to me.